Now we get into our spring pruning. And as far as timing goes, well, spring. That's when you get into your hybrid teas, your floribundas, your grandifloras. Timing is important. You should do it in late winter, early spring. Your pruning should happen when the worst of the winter weather is over. So we're choosing this rose because it gives us lots of opportunity. There's lots of canes, both old and new. It's got some deadwood. It's got some spindly canes. There's lots to do on this. I hope you have some roses that look like this. I know a lot of you don't, but there's always hope. You can always go to the nursery and get a new rose. I know the nurseries love me for saying this, but life is too short to just deal with a wimpy, dying rose. So here's what you need to do. I've got it all listed. You've got skinny canes. You've got rubbing canes, deadwood, just all kinds of stuff. But we're going to take this a piece at a time. So let's get started. We always start with the deadwood removal. So that's pretty obvious. Get rid of that. We've got some spindly canes to get rid of. We've got some rubbing. Then we'll go after some of the big canes. Here we have removed several large canes, leaving plenty of newer canes. You can see quite a difference here. But those old canes, they've done their job. It's time for them to go. We'll rely on the new ones now. A good example of the old cane versus new canes. We've already made one cut on the far right. We're going to go after that one in the center. This old cane has some really nice, vibrant young canes coming out of the base of it. So I would not remove the entire cane to the base. I would cut above those new green canes. A good example of a cane that should just be taken out. It not only has spindly shoots coming out of it, but it's had a rough life. You can see some other problems. So just get rid of it. This rose has lots of options, so no sense trying to get this to do anything. We've now removed some of the other large canes. You can see a real shape developing here. We try to make the rose kind of like an open hand facing up with airspace in the center. Your rose will be healthier if you have airspace and room for the sun to hit the various parts of the rose bush. Also, when you're pruning, you prune to an outside-facing bud. That way, the growth will continue to go out as opposed to into the bush. When you have all the shoots coming into a bush, it just gets chaotic and you have more disease potential. So cut to an outside-facing bud. Another large cut at the base on the right there. I'm going to give you a little close-up of that. You notice that I have made my cut just above the new canes. They have a lot of potential. A lot of folks want to make an angled cut so that the moisture runs off of your pruning cuts. Something like this, you cannot do it. It's just too hard. So just don't worry about it. Don't stress about what angle your cuts are. Just make the cuts, remove the canes. You'll be fine. So this is what we're left with. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 canes remaining. And they all look like an upright hand. They're spread out, all cut to outward-facing buds. Looks good to me. You may have forgotten what we started out with. Well, this is what it looked like. It had lots of stuff in there. We had to get rid of it. And now we're left with this beautiful hybrid tea rose. We generated lots of debris. But don't worry, this rose will do just fine. In fact, a year after I pruned it, it was pretty much back to its original self, and it bloomed its head off all summer long.